Macros allow for powerful handling and automation of an instrument's modulation and effects parameters. In Renoise, this is controlled with the instrument macro's track effect, while Redux uses the options available within its host. Pressing the macros button at the top left of the sampler interface will open a panel with 8 macros, each of which can be assigned to multiple parameters. To begin mapping a macro, just press the button next to it. This opens the mappings list and highlights any mappable parameters. They're shown here as green, but the highlight colour can vary according to the current interface theme. Clicking on a parameter will add it to the list and allow you to specify its min-max values and scaling. Now, altering the value of a macro will change the values of all assigned parameters. Clicking the X at the right of a mapping will delete it. And closing the mappings list returns the interface to normal again. To rename a macro, just click on its name and type 1 in, finishing with Enter. In Renoise, macros are also available in the Instrument Properties section that can be opened up and customized under the Instrument Selector. This provides you with easy access to the macros while using the pattern editor or mixer. To begin automating the macros, add an instrument macros device into the track's effect chain and select the desired instrument. This device provides a copy of the linked instrument's macros, which you can then automate with the usual methods. Additionally, the instrument's phrase can be changed with the menu at the top right. And you probably also noticed the MIDI controls here, which can be automated as well. Like the macros, these are copies of the linked instrument's MIDI macros, found just to the left of the on-screen keyboard and representing pitch bend, a mod wheel, and channel pressure. These MIDI macros can also be mapped by clicking the buttons underneath and setting them up via the same method as before. If you have a hardware controller connected that sends pitch bend, mod wheel, and channel pressure MIDI messages, then it will work automatically with these controls. Finally, for recording and playing live, The MIDI Mapping feature can be used to bind the macros to a hardware controller. While the MIDI macros can't be bound on the instrument itself, since they're already set up to work with specific messages, you can do this via the instrument macros device.